for the singing of our national anthem. Introducing the starting lineup for the Queen's Gaels. At guard, number 4, Rochelle Roberts. At guard, 7, Supreme Singh. At forward, number 9, Nicola Mislyanovich. At forward, number 14, Ryle Stroud. And at guard, number 21,
welcome to SSN's coverage of Ravens basketball for the second half of the doubleheader. The first half won by the hometown Ravens just barely over the Queen's Gaels. This one looks to be another exciting game, with the Ravens coming off a midweek game where they solidly beat the number 2 team in the country, the University of Ottawa Gigi's. The Queen's men's team comes into this struggling at 7-7. The Ravens, of course, undefeated at 14-0. Entry to Tyson. Kicks it out to Phil Scrub. A good start for Phil Scrub, knocking down the baseline three. Queens, Rashane Roberts bringing the ball up. Back to Rashane Roberts. Pass to the post. Isolation on the left wing. Stroud called for the moving screen at the high post. Talking to Coach Smart before this game, he talked about one of the keys being getting to the Gaels bench. He wants to push the pace so much that they're forced into their bench a little bit deeper than they would normally like to go. Ravens running their high set. Tyson rolling out to the perimeter, kicking it out, getting a bit lucky to complete the pass to Phil. Back into hands in the point at the post. Backing his man in. No double team comes, so he'll shoot. Missing it. Rebound. Greg Faulkner. The Carleton transfer. Faulkner taking hard, full court, goes all the way. Tipped out off the Ravens, 18 seconds left on the shot clock. Singh will inbound. Into Roberts, coming off the ball screen. Pass off to Faulkner. Mislinovic kicks it out to Roberts on the offside. Ravens there to challenge. Missed the shot. Tyson with the rebound. Ravens off and running. Phil Scrub in transition. Penetrates. Kicks to a post. Kevin Churchill's first shot of the game is good. From what the Ravens call the Russian spot. Clinton Springer-Williams picking up Singh. Faulkner with the ball, key scorer for the Gaels. Off the flare screen, he attacks off the dribble, kicks it out. Ravens equal to the task, don't give up the shot. One-on-one in the post with Churchill. And Mislinovic knocking it down. 5-2 in the early going for the Ravens. Clinton Springer-Williams attacks from the wing and knocks it down. His own answer. Now defending in the full court, Singh gives the ball up to Roberts. You'll see Greg Faulkner being surrounded by the Ravens defenders quite early in his penetration. One of the key scorers, as I mentioned, for the Gaels. And we've got the Ravens forcing the turnover off the travel by Singh. Hins with the ball. The veteran Hins into Phil Scrub. And they'll go to their traditional high set. Pass into Churchill, out to Tommy Scrub, kicks it to Tyson in the post, who misses the layup, but draws the foul. And I think we're looking at a foul on Stroud. Oh. Apologies, that was Mislinovic. And that's his first personal. Hins to the line for two. Bill Arden flying solo on the SSN coverage tonight. Bringing you the play-by-play and every so often a little bit of color commentary in this one. Where the Ravens lead 8-2 on that second of two free throws by Tyson Hins. Ravens pick up full as they will for most of the game. Roberts brings the ball up for the Gaels, giving it up to Stroud. Out to Faulkner. The Gaels moving the ball well, although around the perimeter. Still not penetrating. Singh with the ball. Doesn't cross it over well. Singh made no play to recover the ball, assuming that it was going to be called on the tip off the Ravens defender. Coach Barry wondering about the call himself, but nonetheless, Ravens ball. Phil Scrub passes off to his brother Tommy. Back to Phil. Back to Tommy and into the post. We'll see how Gale's going to play it. Kicked back out. And a nifty little soccer play by Tyson Hins. Caught by the official, though. Tyson does kick the ball up to his hands. And once again, the Ravens showing their full court man-to-man pressure. Inbounder Faulkner gets the ball back. Crosses half court. Gets it back to Roberts to set the offense. The Gaels swing the ball to Mislinovic. He attacks into the post. Kevin Churchill defending in the post. A double down by Springer-Williams. Pretty good defense by the Ravens, but nonetheless, the Gaels come away with the bucket once again. 8-4. Ravens lead. Phil Scrub off to Clinton Springer-Williams. Springer-Williams attacks, kicks it back to the perimeter. Swing to Phil Scrub. Pretty good D by the Gaels. Offensive board from behind by Tyson Hins and the putback again by Hins. 10-4 Ravens. Roberts up the court. Now this is the kind of pace that the Ravens want. I'm not sure if you're the Queens coaching staff. You don't want to just pull that out and set your set offense and get a few more touches on the ball. Make this Ravens team have to defend for a while and a fair amount of the shot clock. Handoff to the inbounder, Singh. He comes off the ball screen, looking to attack. He kicks it out. Kevin Churchill tips the pass. High ball screen by Faulkner. He rolls perimeter. Oh, Singh may be called for the travel. Yes, he is. And we'll have Carleton ball with the Gaels dropping back. Mackenzie Simpson in to give Roberts a little bit of a rest. And I'd expect we'll see that Singh brings the ball up, if not Faulkner, depending on the matchup. Phil Scrub setting the familiar high set. Pass to Kevin Churchill. Tyson slips it. Tyson with the rebound and the putback, missing it. Rebound by the Gaels. They look to run. There's Faulkner. And look and see the early traffic near Faulkner. And there's Singh, the recipient of the double team. Greg Faulkner double teamed. Singh catches it out of the double team and knocks it down. And that'll hurt the Ravens defenders. 10-6 Ravens lead. 5 minutes and 12 seconds left in the first quarter. Ravens attacking in transition. Clinton Springer-Williams drawing the foul. Drawing the foul from Singh. That's his first personal. Clinton Springer-Williams to the line for two. And we'll look to see Victor Rozel checking into the game for CSW. Springer-Williams good on both. And that'll earn him a rest as Victor Rozel checks into the game to pick up full court on Singh. Mackenzie Simpson looking to come back and help out. Defended by Phil Scrub. They get the ball into Faulkner, as I mentioned. And back to Singh. Singh being defended by Rozel, who played great defense and great offense against the University of Ottawa, knocking down three threes in that lopsided victory. Faulkner on a back door. And that'll get him going. Knocks it down on the layup and draws the foul. Coach Smart not happy about letting this great scorer get off on a backdoor cut. 12-8, the Ravens lead. Make that 12-9 as Faulkner completes the traditional three-point play. And Queens picking up a bit more in the three-quarter court. Mackenzie Simpson on Victor Rozel. Tommy Scrub with the ball, enters the ball into Churchill in the post. No double down coming, so he'll repost. He'll take the ball in. Could be a good night for the Ravens post if the Queens game plan is to not double down. And that's tough. A rebound the Gaels should have had. A sloppy kick out to Phil Scrub. Defended well by Faulkner, and still he knocks it down, and that's why he's the best player in Canada. He makes something from nothing all the time. 15-9, the Ravens lead. 4 minutes left in the first quarter. Faulkner with the ball. Passes the ball in to Stroud. Mackenzie Simpson with it. Looking to get to the rim. Kicks it out to Singh. Singh calling for a high ball screen. He gets it from Stroud. Still with the ball, though, not the greatest offense. With the shot clock running out, though, it comes off the rim. We've got a new shot clock for these Golden Gaels. Singh calms things down. Faulkner with the ball in the wing. Attacking the rim. Ravens defense ready, but the kick out to Mackenzie Simpson leading to an open three. Air ball leading to a Phil Scrub bust out. Phil to brother Tommy. He attacks in transition. But Tommy Scrub is called on the charge. You know, the Queens defense looking good there. But Singh and Mislinovich looking like they really need to come off. And in fact, they do get an opportunity. Milan Mitrovic into the game for the first time for the Gaels. And Shane Roberts returning at the point guard spot. And here he is with the ball against Victor Rozel. Mirovic swings the basketball. Greg Faulkner left open. That will not leave Dave Smart happy. his game plan with Faulkner is to make him put the ball on the floor, draw the early help, and see if the kick out can be rotated to. He does not want to let him get going with his open shots. Speaking of open shots, Tyson sets the screen and rolls perimeter, but he misses. And Jean-Pierre Charles with the offensive board, mind you, and there's Tyson getting another opportunity, but this time inside, he finishes, and the Ravens pick up full court. Inbounder Faulkner gets the ball back to bring it up. The Ravens will trap him to get the ball out of his hands. Queen swings the ball. High ball screen being called for by Faulkner. He'll attack. He's feeling good now. And sure enough, he knocks it down. This is one thing that's a theme of Dave Smart. If you let a good scorer get off and confident, then he starts hitting tough shots. And it's exactly what's happening here right now. But there's another facet of Dave Smart's coaching. You've got to attack the great scorer at the other end. You know, great scorers, you got to make them defend. And there's Tommy Scrum attacking from the wing with his matchup, Greg Faulkner fouling him. In fact, Faulkner will get, with the only one foul, a breather. And he's feisty. He's going to want to get back in as soon as he can. But he's off for a breather. Tommy Scrub finishing the traditional three-point play. Carleton leads 20-14 with 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Carleton picking up full, showing double team on Rashane Roberts, the point guard. Victor Razzo against Mackenzie Simpson. Now it's back to Rashane Roberts with Connor Wood on him, checked into the game for the Ravens. Jean-Pierre Charles jumping to the ball, not getting hit by that, what's called the UCLA screen, or the screen at the high post. And the pass incomplete off Queens, Ravens ball. Connor Wood with the ball on the wing, being aggressively hand-checked. He'll have to square down, and he does. Ravens swing, Phil Scrub attacks, looks to kick out for Connor Wood, who can shoot this shot in his sleep, and he does make the three. Immediately gets into full court man D. There's Roberts with the ball. Ravens lead 23-14. Connor Wood defending Roberts. Kicked out to Minovich. Roberts again with the ball up top. Double high, double ball screen. With 5 seconds on the shot clock, Street shooting the shot, getting his own rebound eventually, but called for the travel on the putback. It'll be Carleton ball with Singh heading back into the game for Mackenzie Simpson.
And number nine, Nikola
Mislintovich. Back into the game for the Gaels after a brief respite. Phil Scrub with the ball, bringing it up. Connor Wood with wing entry. High post for Jean-Pierre Charles. Back door by Phil Scrub. Now he'll come for the handoff. He'll turn the corner off the ball screen. Kicks it out to Connor Wood, who just hit the last three. Misses that one, but follows and creates an offensive rebounding opportunity for the Ravens. 1 minute remaining with a new shot clock. Into the post, Tyson kicks it out to Connor, who attacks the closeout. Left open is Tyson Hinz. He makes no mistake. Ravens lead 25-14 with 43 seconds, left in the first quarter. Singh with the ball, calling for the high ball screen. He gets it. Tyson hedges. Singh attacking Connor Wood. Makes it all the way to the rim and the bucket. And the Ravens look for a counterattack. Singh challenging the wing entry pass. Called tipped out. Singh after that rest looking to make an impact on this game and really playing well. Coach Steph Berry knows it's 7-7 against the nation's number one team. He's going to need a lot of things to go right tonight, but his team's certainly given great effort in the early going. But the game plan of leaving the post to a one-on-one battle is a mistake some teams have made. And when you're going up against Tyson Inns, he'll make you pay in that low post if you can leave him one-on-one, and he does there. end after one. We've got the Ravens leading 27-16. You're listening to Bill Arden on the Streaming Sports Network, and we'll take a break.
The Queens Gaels, 16. Enter with the leader captain of the game by visiting our promotions table at the front of the Ravens nest. The winner will be announced in the third quarter. The Ottawa Sports Page is a proud partner of the Carleton Ravens. Pick up a copy of the newspaper on today's game to get all your latest local amateur sports news. Kids, visit the Ottawa Sports Page Kids Zone at the back of the Ravens nest. The Ottawa Sports Page, the heartbeat of the Ottawa sports community. And now, here's Nick, the Carleton Conspiracy Batman, under the direction of Nick Dyson.
Welcome back after that brief and entertaining interlude by the Carleton game band, similar to NCAA game staging. A real wonderful addition to the evening that you enjoy at Carleton when you enjoy a doubleheader. Again, earlier the Ravens women's team winning in a close one over the Queens Golden Gaels. Right here we have Carleton men team leading Queens 27-16 at the start of the second quarter. Connor Wood picking up Singh. Faulkner back into the game for the Gaels, being forced out of bounds. And we'll have Ravens ball inbound to Phil Scrub. High screen being set by Kevin Churchill. Phil Scrub uses it. Queens ready for the set play. Singh attacks off penetration. Wasn't able to get all the way. Has to reset the offense. High ball screen. He rejects it. Now he'll use it. Swing to Faulkner. That time he was checked well by Phil Scrub. Phil Scrub attacking in transition. Finishing the layup. Roberts looking to come back with his own transition game. Queens swing the basketball. Singh with it up top. Again, wing entry. Roberts looking to attack Phil Scrub one-on-one. Not able to. A challenged three by Mislanovic. And he makes good on it. 29-19, Ravens lead. Tommy Scrub with the ball. Jean-Pierre Charles mishandles the pass but is able to collect it. Phil Scrub again with attack from the wing. He'll kick to the offside to his brother Tommy, who makes good on that kick-out three-point shot. And we've got a 32-19 lead by the Ravens. Great hustle by Tommy Scrub in transition on D. And in fact, it was a Queens foul called. Well, that was Ryan Stroud, and his second gives him a chance for a breather. As we have Mike Shoveler, a first-year post, coming into the game, I believe, for the first time. And he'll cover Kevin Churchill in the post to start his shift. One-on-one in the post, Kevin Churchill spins baseline and finishes the layup. I'm not sure if Coach Barry will need to change this game plan and come with some sort of a double team. Faulkner goes back door and then posts up. catches the ball in the post. We'll see if a double comes. I think one is. Yes, Jean-Pierre Charles is ready to go. Kicked out to Singh. Swung to Roberts, who misses the three. Churchill with the ball. Outlet to Phil Scrub. Carlton looking to push the ball and push the pace. Phil Scrub hits Churchill in the rushing spot. He'll turn his back to the basket and start his work in the post. Once again, it's one-on-one, so he'll shoot. And it's a layup drill for the Carlton posts if the defensive game plan continues to be the same. And with Tyson Hinds ready to check back in after being rested, I'm sure he'll be coming in for Churchill simply to give Churchill a blow. And the Carlton defense, again, Churchill forcing the turnover. Pass up to Connor Wood. He passes back to Phil Scrub to set the offense. Churchill out to set the ball screen. Phil rejects it, goes baseline, kicks it out to his brother. Kicks it back to his brother, Phil. Misses the three. Good ball movement once again by the Ravens. Singh carries the ball away. Looking to attack, no room. Kicks it out to Roberts. Again, no room for the attack, but he's still trying. There's Faulkner. He'll try to get the shot off. We've got ourselves a travel where he had nowhere to go, and you've got to say that the Ravens' D is kind of smothering this Gaels team. In fact, Coach Barry wanted to talk it over with his troops, get organized on what the game plan is, probably offensively, and we'll see if he makes any adjustments defensively. You're listening to Bill Arden on the Streaming Sports Network. We'll take a break. Announcer at the Ravens Nest mentioning that this isn't the only men's matchup between Queens and Carleton. Queens and Carleton are playing in hockey at the Ice House, and it's 3-2 Carleton after the second period. But right here, we've got Carleton leading 36-19 with Phil Scrub open for the kick-out three and knocking it down. Three steps outside the three-point line. He can simply play the game, and Carleton with their spacing are really tough to defend, especially when they're knocking down shots like that. Singh attacks the rim, kicks it out to the perimeter. The Gaels with a three-point shot of their own missing, but Mackenzie Simpson with the offensive rebound drawing the foul as well.
Foul against number 10, Connor Wood. His first personal foul.
Connor Wood committing the foul, and he'll get a chance to think about it for a while as Clinton Springer-Williams checks back into the game. Queen's ball on the baseline. Faulkner off a curl cut, not able to get the shot off. Kicks it out to the inbounder, Singh. Into the post, but Tyson Hinds called on a hand check early on the catch.
Carlton fouled against number 42, Tyson Hinds. His first personal foul.
Gaels again with the ball, 18 seconds on the shot clock. Faulkner, beautiful pass in to Shoveler, who misses the layup. A great pass. Well, certainly we knew when Greg was playing here that he was a gifted athlete, good basketball player, a natural scorer, works hard on his game. And you saw a bit of his brilliance there. Backdoor cut by Simpson, missing the layup. Shoveler, though, better on that attempt. 39-21, the Ravens lead. Clinton Springer-Williams with the ball on the wing. He looks for post entry into Churchill. Churchill being isolated in the post, no double down. He'll repost. Bit of a miscommunication leads to a Faulkner breakout and a layup. Faulkner making good on that one. Again, we've got post-entry to Churchill. We'll see if he does better here. Singh threatening to double down. Spin baseline, kick out baseline. Tommy Scrub attacks the closeout, kicks it out to Clinton Springer-Williams, who makes good on his three. Great spacing, great ball movement, great shooting. This is Ravens offense to a T. 42-23, they lead the Gaels with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in the first half. Hand off to Faulkner, who shoots the three. Wide, Phil Scrub with an offense or the defensive rebound and a breakout. Looking to run the Ravens offense, he attacks. Kicks it out sloppily to his brother Tommy. Springer-Williams, who just hit. Long on that attempt, but the Ravens, they come away with the offensive board. Again, Scrub mishandling the ball. Entering the ball into the post, Kevin Churchill working one-on-one. Working one-on-one, kicks it back out to Phil Scrub. Phil Scrub hits it like it's a free throw. And it's 45-23. Queens wanting to talk it over yet again. Coach Barry reminding Singh not to double down and leave Phil Scrub open for that. In fact, she's talking to him all the way into the timeout. Welcome back from the timeout. We've got Carleton up 45-23. Queens calling the timeout to discuss the defensive game plan. But here they are on offense. Getting it into the post. Kick out to Mackenzie Simpson. Missing the three. Tommy Scrub comes away with the defensive rebound. Singh called for the reach from behind. And I think he's going to have to take a seat with a second foul. And yes, we'll see Roberts come back into the game. Roberts into the game as well as Jean-Pierre Charles. As well out of the stoppage, we see Victor Razzo has checked back into the game. Catches the inbound pass, post entry to Tyson, but Razzo actually guilty of stepping on the sideline. I want to give a shout-out to my friend Howard Bloom, not able to make it here tonight, and I'm bringing you a bit of color every so often and as much play-by-play as I can. Right now, your Ravens lead 45-23, 3.5 minutes left in the half. Queens working the ball around the perimeter, hand off to Faulkner, kicks it out. Roberts with the ball. Simpson shoots the three, tries to draw the foul with the fall, instead misses the three. Ravens come away with it in transition. Again, the Ravens said they were going to look to run all night long. Post entry to Tyson. We'll see if the double down comes now, but no, they're leaving him. But he's being called on the offensive foul with the reach around. And we'll see Kevin Churchill checking into the game for Hens. Ravens picking up full court. Queens passes the ball back to the inbounder, Faulkner. Hoffner to Simpson. Post pops out high. Comes to, fakes the ball screen. And a hand check called on defense. Jean-Pierre Chauve. I'm not sure these are the types of calls you'd get in any other situation. That's not really a physical play right there. But it is a sloppy defensive play to be hand checking like that. You're up 22 points. You'd like to see the Ravens moving their feet more and less clutch and grab. Faulkner cuts back door. Up to Roberts. Open for the three. Misses it. Tommy Scrubb with a defensive board. Passes over to Churchill in transition. The handoff to Phil Scrubb. I was surprised he didn't take that the way he's shooting tonight. Pierre Charles up to the high post. Back to Scrubb for an isolation. He penetrates. He kicks to Victor Razzo on the offside. And Victor Razzo knocks down a kick-out three. When all the Ravens shooters are knocking down kick-out threes, it is very difficult to defend. I'm not even sure how you would. 48-23 with 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Ravens lead. Mislanovic in the post working away and draws the foul. Coach Smart pretty upset with his team's defensive play in the last few minutes. Thinks they've lost a bit of focus and they're fouling instead of defending fundamentally. And you know, Mislanovic has really come to play tonight. He's tried to get shots off in all situations, perimeter and post. Defensively, he's tried to be really active. And he knocks down the first of two. With Queens not looking to come in to rebound at all. They stayed in the huddle a little bit too long. He'll have to knock this down as there's no Queens rebounders. He makes good on it. 48-25. Ravens lead by 23. Tommy Scrubb with the ball up top. Pass it into the post. Kicked out to Phil Scrubb. Phil Scrubb attacks baseline. Gets knocked. Misses the layup, but will go to the line for two. Well, he's a tough matchup at the best of times, but Phil Scrubb knocking down threes is a very tough matchup because, unlike some other shooters who, when you make them put it on the floor, they have trouble finishing, Phil Scrubb has it all. Yeah, and you know, that's a good point. Cameraman uses the word effortless, and he really makes the game look effortless, and it is. You know, it's a great effort put into developing his skill and developing what he's got. But he shoots three-point shots like they're foul shots. He defends smoothly and intelligently. He attacks the rim. His first step is as good as anyone in the nation, so he's really got it all. Roberts with the ball up top. Flare screen utilized. Open three. Patrick Street makes no mistake. They needed that. 50-28. Minute and a half left in the half. Victor Razzo on the wing. Post entry to Churchill. He'll go to work and wait and see what the Gaels do. They leave him one-on-one. He spins baseline and then the double comes. Street with the foul.
Queens foul against number 11, Patrick Street. His first personal foul in the ballgame now for Carleton. Number 10, Connor Wood.
Not a shooting foul, so Ravens will take the ball out on the baseline. Connor Wood off a curl. Has the ball on the wing. Feeds Kevin Churchill in the post. Not a clean catch, but it kicks it out to Connor anyway. Connor shoots and knocks down the three. And we see, number 41, or sorry, 31, Guillaume Bouchard into the game for his first action tonight. Queens worked the ball to the baseline, missed shot. Tommy Scrubb with the defensive board. Comes away with it. Kevin Churchill in the post. Ravens guards switch their position on the perimeter as they do on all low post entry. Spin and a finish again by a Ravens post. Kevin Churchill with 35 seconds left brings the lead 55-28 for the Ravens. Queens swing the basketball. Patrick Street over to Mislanovic. Over to Faulkner, who pulls it out for a reset. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Hedge, kick back, finish the swing. No, they don't finish the swing. And as a result, they don't get the shot off. Great D, though, by these Ravens. And with 13 seconds left, up 55-28, Coach Smart does not choose to call a timeout for a set play. Instead, he'll let his team sort it out on their own set call. High ball screen, swing, penetration, Tommy Scrub attacking, kicks it to his brother, Phil Scrub, the step back, and almost knocks that down. And we go into the half with the Ravens leading 55-28. We'll have a halftime break and enjoy the second half here at the Ravens Nest. You're listening to Bill Arden on the Streaming Sports Network. Welcome back to the Ravens Nest, where your Ravens lead the Queen's Golden Gaels 55-28 at the start of the third quarter. You know, the stats sort of tell the story here in that Carleton held the Gaels to 42% shooting, which actually is a decent percentage in basketball. Though the Gaels only shooting 33% on 3-for-9 from the long range. And only getting 3 foul shots, but hitting on all of them for 100%. So the Gaels actually shooting the ball decently this evening. That said, the Ravens percentages for the first half. From the field, 62.5%, including 60% from the three-point line. That's tough against any opponent when the Ravens are hitting them with that accuracy. And we start off with Tommy Scrubb receiving a high ball screen from Kevin Churchill. The Gaels switch it. They go at the mismatch. Churchill versus Faulkner in the post. Singh dips down. He's been active all night, really. Tries to draw the foul a little bit too aggressively and misses his own layup. Phil Scrubb brings the ball up against Singh. Kicks it out to brother Tommy, who attacks baseline. Kicks it out baseline. And this Queens team has come to play in the second half, at least at the opening, defensively. And you like to see that spirit. Sometimes teams have a tendency to quit down 55-28 at the Ravens Nest, but this Queens team, certainly in the early going, looking to make a mark. Roberts off to Singh. Back to Roberts at the point. The Ravens doing a great job defensively. They've been certainly overplaying Greg Faulkner, trying to keep the ball out of his hands. Roberts off the inbounds with 8 seconds left in the shot clock. Singh takes it in. Attacks hard, Clinton Springer-Williams.
Carleton foul against number 5, Clinton Springer-Williams. His first personal foul.
Now that's CSW's first foul, but nonetheless, Coach Smart, well, I know what that sub's all about, even though he's not in foul trouble and it's early in his shift. Gave up the penetration right. And all of the Ravens players know that if you've got a right-handed player and you actually allow him to go to his strong hand clean, you're coming off. Oh, then the Gaels show a 2-2-1 or a 2-1-2 full court press and almost turn the Ravens over. Ravens looked a little bit stymied by that press. Maybe losing a little bit of focus. You know, the Ravens lost a bit of focus in the third quarter against the Gigi's, albeit the Gigi's stepped up the pressure and played like the number 2 team in the country and really dominated the Ravens for a few minutes. And we've got Queens starting out this third quarter with some aggressive, positive energy for sure. And the double down in the post leading to a turnover and a Ravens foul. And we've got another third quarter struggle for these Ravens. Tyson Hinds called on the reach, committing his third foul, though Coach Smart not looking to the bench to get him off at this point. Roberts receiving the double screen up top. Turns the corner, passes it beautifully to the post. Drawing the foul is Stroud. Coach Smart not happy with his Ravens defenders right now, and Connor Wood being talked to by the coach. Tyson Hinds off, as I said, with 3 fouls. Kevin Churchill bringing the ball up. Back to Phil Scrubb. Ball screen on the wing. They look to swing it. Connor Wood mishandles the pass. Queens putting a little bit more pressure on in this second half. I'm not sure the call went the right way. Thought that was tipped off Queens, but not a lot of argument, so we'll see. Victor Rosso into the ball game for Connor Wood. Oh, and Queens commits an unforced error themselves. Singh turns the ball over. And Jean-Pierre Charles will inbound the ball from the sideline. Phil Scrubb sets the offense. Victor Razzo, left wing. Cross screen for the Ravens. Looking high, low game. Kevin Churchill catches the pass and goes to work. Spins baseline, kicks it baseline. Queens playing much better defense in this third quarter than they were in the first half. The miss and the rebound. Greg Faulkner kicks it out to Singh. Threatens the shot. Coach Smart has had enough. Wondering about the calls. But he needs to get his team motivated to get sharp fundamentally on defense. Get down in stance and get it done. Great take, great first step by Faulkner. Makes no mistake on the pull-up. 55-34, your Ravens lead. And the Gaels off to a 6-0 run to start the second half. Phil Scrubb trying to end that, missing. Roberts away on the run, looking to attack on the fly. Victor Razzo, he kicks it out. Gets it back. Again, penetrates. Draws the foul from Victor Razzo, and this Queens team playing much better in the third quarter. 55-34 with 7 minutes left, with Roberts heading to the line. And actually, we'll see Gavin Resch for his first time tonight. Coming in for Victor Razzo. Dave Smart looking for some solution to his defensive woes. Roberts trying to make good on one at least, and he does, making the run 7-0 to open the second half, and the Gaels pick up with their 2-1-2 zone pressure. The Ravens this time handle it fairly easily. Phil Scrubb with the ball in the penetration, gets the ball back. Gavin Resch finishes the swing to Tommy. Shot missed, and the Ravens are scoreless so far in the second half. Singh attacks with a crossover. A really nice take in transition. And Coach Smart not entirely sure when his team is going to show up to defend. And you have to respect this Queens team for not quitting. Gavin Resch, the recipient of a kickout pass from a Phil Scrubb penetration. And he makes no mistake to get Carleton its first points of the second half. 58-37, the Ravens lead. We'll see if that leads to a bit better team defense at this end. I'm not sure that's the shot you want if you're Coach Barry. Ravens come away with it. Gavin with the ball. Kicks it to Phil Scrubb. Hand check called on Supreet Singh. Now he's getting tired anyway. He's going to have to come off with three fouls for a little bit of a rest. Ottawa native, the Glebe Collegiate grad, Mackenzie Simpson, checks into the game again. Along with Patrick Street, who played decently in the first half, I thought. Inbound, back to Scrubb. Ball screen on the wing. Phil Scrubb. Churchill slips it, gets it in the post, goes to work, no double down yet. Kick out to Phil Scrubb, who knocks it down. And the Ravens were scoreless for the first few minutes, but they've hit the last two threes for six quick ones. Phil Scrubb playing well again tonight, but the Ravens on the ball defenders not getting it done. Not getting the ball to be forced left. The first component of the Dave Smart defensive system. And certainly not getting it done right now. Already committing five fouls in this quarter with 5 minutes and 35 seconds left. The Ravens did not come out sharp and ready to play. And as a result, they find themselves in foul troubles. Queens will have to hit these shots with no defenders on. And Mackenzie Simpson goes only one for two, but the allowing the Gaels to set up their pressure nonetheless. Ravens being tentative. Mackenzie Simpson, though, being aggressive on Phil Scrub, being called. That's Queens only their second foul of the quarter to the Ravens' five. Greg Faulkner getting a rest as the Ravens look to regroup, bring it up court. Phil Scrub clears out the wing, kicks it out. Gavin Resch off the swing, and he knocks it down, two for two. And that's nice to see. Gavin Resch working hard on his game lately, and nice to see him get an opportunity here against Queens, and nice to see him do something with it. That's 6 points early. We'll see what he can do at the defensive end. Mackenzie Simpson in the post against Jean Charles. That's two fouls in a row when Jean-Pierre Charles is forced to guard the ball. I think he'll be subbing off to think about it for a little while. And it's the hoop and the harm. Yes, we'll see Connor Wood come in for Jean. And Coach Smart offering some sage advice to the player out of Ashbury. And we'll get a substitute throw and another opportunity for Mackenzie Simpson to finish the three-point play. I believe we had a violation in too soon. By number 11, Tommy Scrub. Tommy Scrub with that rebound. Still a missed foul shot. Phil Scrub asking for space from Connor Wood. Kevin Churchill catches it in the post. The guards switch places. Double down, leaving Phil Scrub open for a three. Not sure that's what you want to do. Oh, Gavin Resch trying to get an offensive board, but lands out of bounds. And we have Milan Mitrovic subbing into the game for Patrick Street. And Mark Paklabar into the game for the Gaels at the guard spot. And I did not see him in the first half, so I think he's getting his first action. Enters it to the high post. Coming off the curl is Mitrovic. He looks to pass it back to the guard. Paklabar using the ball screen, turns it over, however. Gavin Resch coming up the floor, kicks it to Tommy in the middle. Who hits it on the run. Roberts right back in transition. The floater does not go, and the Ravens look to run as well. This is not the pace that Queens wants to play at, especially not against the number one team in the nation. Kevin Churchill catching the ball in the post, going to work with the dribble. No double down, he'll spin and shoot. Missing, however, and Queens comes away with a defensive rebound. And off we go with Paklabar setting up the offense. Swing to a three. Not made by Mitrovic. Phil Scrub up to Connor Wood on the wing. He attacks the rim, finishes the layup. And again, this is not the pace you want to play. Carleton up 68-40, 3.5 minutes left. And they've regained that 28-point lead. Mackenzie Simpson off a curl cut, catches the ball in the middle and finishes.
Mackenzie Simpson.
Carleton defense trailing the cut. Church out on the wing to set a ball screen for Phil Scrub. He slips it to the post. Hand check called on Paklabar. Coach Barry wondering about that call and getting an explanation as we speak. Carleton ball on the sideline. Tommy Scrub off for a rest, and we see Guillaume Boucard into the game again. Good long stretch for Gavin Resch. That's nice to see. Of course, he's knocked down two threes, and he hasn't been noticeable on the defensive end, which is what Coach Smart wants. He wants him to get the job done defensively. He knows he can shoot the ball. Kevin Churchill with the turnover saved by the Queens foul. Mike Shoveler commits, I believe, his second personal. I could be wrong on that. No, it is his first. But nonetheless, he subs off. Ryle Stroud into the game again. And Queens will pick up on defense as the Ravens will have a baseline inbounds opportunity with 2:52 left and up 68-42. The Ravens will be here again tomorrow night for a doubleheader taking on New York Lions, who, of course, are crosstown at the University of Ottawa last night. York men not being welcomed into the town very well, giving up 67 points to Ottawa U in only the first half and down 30 already to the number two team in the nation. Queens committing a foul, and Bill Scrub to the line for two. Makes good on the first, 69-42. Singh back in for Paklabar, who did a decent job out there, all but the except for the last foul. Coach let him know he wasn't too happy with that type of defense. Singh bringing the ball up against Connor Wood, passing it off to Street, back to Singh. Street with the ball, hands it off. Not getting anywhere though. They're not getting deep penetration. They're having to reset the offense late in the shot clock. Singh gets the shot off, mind you. Churchill with the rebound. Pretty good Ravens defense there, and they look to run. Phil Scrub in transition, forced to kick it out. Gavin Resch catches it, and then post-entry, the guards switch places. Churchill goes to work. He spins baseline. He spins back into the middle, and he finishes the layup. 72-42. Ravens lead by 32 minutes left in the third. Singh at the top, off the Street. Dribble handoff to Mackenzie Simpson. Uses the ball screen, sets a ball screen. Singh tries to cross over. Phil Scrub ready for it. Getting ready to check in is Victor Razzo. And he'll come in for the captain and leading player in the country, Phil Scrub. And we'll see if this lead continues, if we see the Carleton great in again. Singh attacks off the inbound play. Gives the ball up, but Queen's not able to collect the pass nor get a shot off before the end of the shot clock. Churchill will inbound to Gavin Resch. I'd like to see Guillaume Boucard get some touches here. And Gavin Resch passes the ball into the defender's hands, and Coach Smart definitely not happy with that, and that certainly won't earn you play time. Singh crosses Gavin Resch over, but he's ready for it. Street pulls up. Resch with the rebound. And he'll bring it up for the Ravens. Connor Wood, wing entry, post entry into Kevin Churchill. Boucard will space to the offside block. Kick out, repost. Churchill, kick out again. Connor Wood can hit that shot. And we've got a Ravens foul off the rebound situation. Guillaume Boucard, I think, being called on a push. Yep. And with a minute left in the third, we're into a bit of sloppy play, and the Ravens giving up the opportunity for Stroud to come down and hit foul shots. And in fact, Boucard is off to learn from his coach, allowing Clinton Springer-Williams back onto the floor. And this is the versatility, you know. Boucard was playing post, and Clinton Springer-Williams, who plays guard, will go back in, and now we'll see either Victor Razzo or Connor Wood, I think, play the four spot, though Springer-Williams definitely physically strong enough to play that position. Churchill out there as the five man, and no, we do see Connor Wood is playing the four. Connor Wood diving to the offside block. Churchill going to work on his own one-on-one. Knocks it down with 47 seconds left, 74-44 for your Carleton Ravens. Street with the ball up top. Swings it. Looking for an isolation on the right wing. Mitrovic with the ball. Gets it to Singh. Again, the Gaels doing a lot of passing on the perimeter, left with really very little attack. So right now the Ravens defense not allowing them to bust through the shell with penetration. And so what we're seeing is a lot of movement leading to very little. 25 seconds left in the third quarter. Gavin Resch takes the ball. Reach foul committed by Mackenzie Simpson. Gavin Resch getting to go to the line for two. Queens coaching staff not happy with that style of defense, and coach quite animated. You know, he's challenging his players to continue playing regardless of the score. You like to see that, and you like to see him asking for a game plan to be adhered to. Nonetheless, we'll take a short break. You're listening to the Streaming Sports Network.
Quick check of the events that have transpired next door at the Ice House. Our final score now, Carleton 3, Queens 2.
Welcome back to the Ravens Nest, where the Carleton Ravens men's basketball team leads the Golden Gaels 74-44, and it looks like it might be a 3 wins for Carleton, 0 wins for Queens kind of night. The women's basketball team beating Queens in the earlier game, and over the Ice House it's just been announced as a final. The Ravens men's hockey team beating Queens 3-2. Gavin Resch to the line for 2 free throws here after the Queens timeout. Missing on the first of 2. Yeah, true enough, he should shoot it from the three-point line with how well he's shooting those tonight. He misses both free throws. Roberts brings the ball up for the Queens Gaels. Off to Mitrovic, back to Roberts. Kind of interesting that we have not seen Faulkner back on in this quarter. Spin move, finished by Patrick Street. At the end of the quarter, the Ravens lead 74-46. We'll take a short break. You're listening to Carleton Basketball on the Streaming Sports Network.
It's time now to reveal our winner of the brand new 34-inch smart TV from our friends at Blinker Stereo and TV. Tonight's winner, Ian.
Welcome back after the quarter break, where your Ravens lead by 28 over the Queens Golden Gaels, 74-46, and Coach Smart was so animated in that stoppage, mainly going after Gavin Resch, but really challenging his whole team. And he wants them to raise the bar on their play, partly worried, I think, about unfocused play leading to injury, but also, quite frankly, because he doesn't believe in playing in context of the scoreboard. He wants focus all the time and possession by possession, winning in that moment, in that competition. Victor Razzo, Clinton Springer-Williams into the game for the Ravens. Once again, we see a Queens player going right. Gavin Resch brings the ball up for the Ravens, over to Victor Razzo. Low post entry for Kevin Churchill, who's played well tonight. He'll spin baseline and finish the shot. And again, the choice by the Gaels not to double down has really led to quite a night. You know, I think you're going to see that Phil Scrub and Kevin Churchill lead all scorers. Gavin Resch allowing the ball to go right. And hearing about it from Kevin Churchill and from his coach. Speaking of Kevin Churchill, he's played a great game this evening, but we see Jean-Pierre Charles subbing in at the five spot. Carleton going with a pretty small lineup right now. 9 minutes left and a 29-point lead, 76-47. Patrick Street good on both free throws. Gavin Resch bringing the ball up for the Ravens. Queens showing a half-court trap. Dropping back, it appears, into a zone. Playing it aggressively. We still don't see Faulkner out. I don't know whether or not that's a choice by the coaching staff to save him for the game tomorrow. I would suspect it is. Springer-Williams. This will be an interesting one. The timing. The referee's crew will have to come together. There was a foul called off the play at the same time as the shot went up and was scored by Springer-Williams. I believe they're going to come out to the decision that the basket counts.